Hello, and welcome to Scarlet Serpent Readings. Thank you so much for joining me for another Timeless Pick a Card reading. In today's reading, we're going to be looking at a past life in a different star system. So hopefully this one's a little more lighthearted, fun, but also insightful and maybe bringing some confirmations of, like, I guess little hints and nudges about just connections to other star systems. So first of all, of course, I want to say thank you so much for those of you who are subscribed, and thank you for watching. I always appreciate it. I really do. Yeah, let's just dive right in. I have three piles, as always. Pile one is going to be this candle. Just a regular candle there, nothing crazy. Pile two is going to be a coin. I think it's yeah, there's no heads or tails. It's like both heads, and then we have a tumbled stone. So pile one is the candle, pile two is the coin, and pile three is the tumbled stone. So take your time, pause the video if you need to. You could find the timestamps in the description box along with information for a personal reading if you're interested. Otherwise, I'll meet you at your pile. Hi, pile one. If you chose the candle, this is going to be your reading. So my intention is to go fairly quickly on this one. But first of all, I don't have any decks that are space themed or anything like that, like Starseed. So I just drew a race out of a little jar that I have here. But that doesn't necessarily mean that it was only from this planet or with this these beings. This is, of course, a collective reading, and I'm going to be drawing some additional cards later, so you might connect those accordingly. But the one that you got is Tall Whites, so you might feel connected to that race. I actually know nothing about them, but well, Tall Whites, it says Tall Whites. It's not really wanting to focus right now, but there we go, Tall Whites. And I have a little spread here. We have a card representing, let me see, what was it? Your personality in this past life, in this other star system. We have your life purpose in the star system, your like a special ability, and then your impact before diving a little bit deeper, okay? So, your personality was the Ten of Cups. Very giving, very nurturing, wanting for everyone to be happy. And I think because your planet, your star system was very advanced spiritually, there's a lot of value in your perspective. There's a lot of value in making sure that not only you were content, happy, loving, but that everyone else around you was, and that all of this together was kind of what brought wisdom on a collective level. I feel like collective wisdom was very important on this star system, and that's what peace was something, of course, that you were striving for, but everyone on the planet was striving for as well. And that's weird. So I have a mandala. It's like a little, it's a blue, yeah, like a poster, and it looks exactly like this, actually. That's weird. It's in blue and green, but similar design, I guess. I don't know why this isn't focusing, so I apologize. But anyway, yeah, a big sense of community, and that was your personality, was being aware of that community, being aware of the impact of other people on the whole, on the collective level. And again, there was a strong sense of importance to that. I think, like, currency wise, it was more based on the energy, the frequency of the individual, as opposed to, like, money. So that might have been a currency that was used, and in that case, you were extremely wealthy. So let's see, your life purpose is the King of Swords. bringing truth, spreading it out. You could have been definitely a warrior of some kind, a warrior against dishonesty, distrust. And it's interesting because your ability, I'm jumping a little ahead, but it goes together in a way, is your ability is the judgment card. So I think you might have been like just like that on some sort of council that kind of judged people based on their energy and kind of dealt it wasn't necessarily punishment, it kind of felt like a rehabilitation in a way. I hope that makes sense. I mean, this is a more far out reading, I guess, but like that's your ability to be discerning and honest, to look into the spirit. There's a little sun inside the person there. And a couple eyes up top as well. So being just to clearly see someone's intent, to clearly see someone's energy and to vocalize it and wield the sword. So I think you're like in a high ranking in this system. I think that you were like a judge of some kind. So if you're kind of maybe in this lifetime kind of thought about law, or at least you just read energy extremely well, especially here. And then we have the impact that you had is the Two of Swords. And I think part of it is seeing the other side of the whole, not being afraid of those that weren't necessarily on the same frequency, but kind of still seeing eye to eye regardless. It's a lot of fire. There's a lot of kind of, it almost looks dark, but I don't think it's meant to be in that way, you know? But like you look into the belly of the beast, I guess, I'm not going to say that, but just trying to bring it real close. There we go. Look at how intense that is. And that was the impact. With the Two of Swords, with the King of Swords, with the Judgment card, it was kind of like, what's his name from Marvel? Ronan, I think it was not the Executioner, I forget, but it was kind of a similar feel. Yeah, like you were the judge, you were someone who, I was going to say dictated people's lives, but not really, not like dictated like that. It was more of being fair, and let's just say a lot of beings respected you across that star system. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to just draw a bunch of cards and see what comes up intuitively. But the Nine of Cups. Lots of cups energy. A lot of energetic awareness in this star system. An attunement to water. Page of Pentacles. You're able to see into the shadows of others. How many of these are in reverse? We're not going to do that. We have the Seven of Swords. So being able to see through deceit was a big part of your life on this star system. And I'm sure that translates here as well. There was a lot of deserts there. There was a lot of water too. Not too much land though, which is interesting. This could be like a more water-based planet. With the Seven of Swords, Knight of Pentacles, so a couple of pentacles coming up. I think because of the nature of your work that you befriended a lot of pentacles to kind of balance your own energy, and we have the Wheel of Fortune. But it wasn't luck. Like the yeah. It's like an energy to be understood with the Wheel of Fortune, which is why maybe you got to this position of being sort of a judge because you were so fair, but it wasn't luck. Again, it was just like a discernment, extremely honest being that people came to for support. It's like that's where it started. Like your humble beginnings were just being attuned to your own energy, and then you started realizing or starting to be proficient in seeing energy of other people, and then you kind of met someone who was like at the bottom ranks of this sort of, I'll say, like a celestial council, and then you were able to look kind of the shadow, the lower vibrational energies in the eye, kind of see the good in them, but still be able to notice when they're lying. And I think that gained recognition. I know this is far out, but kind of gained recognition through that. And then it's kind of like you were tapped into the collective awareness of the universe. And I think, again, like this star system was really advanced. So, and I think maybe if you might not be struggling in this, whoops, sorry about that, on Earth, but kind of sound like a hammer, no? And the strength, yeah, your strength was emotional awareness, and I think that might be something that kind of feels heavy on Earth, is that there isn't so much of an importance on emotional intelligence, on vibration. Right now, we have the Page of Wands. And that feels like all the work, all your intelligence isn't really being noticed, or it hasn't been so far. I think we're going through shifts that'll allow for a use of this power. Yeah, wow. That makes sense. I'm jumping all over. So for the Wheel of Fortune, we have Divine Wisdom, which is a card I think unique to this deck. But it goes to show that you understood the nature of karma, that there wasn't really luck, and that by being honest and just aware, and I think that's why you landed this position, where you could be in charge of something. So it's kind of like instead of going to prison, people would live, be assigned like a certain lifestyle class, and you can make your way out of it by being more loving and being of higher vibration. But you were really important in kind of assigning people to different standards of living, which is why it was so important that you remain honest and diligent in seeing people's energy. And we have Moon Child with the Knight of Pentacles. I think this Knight of Pentacles is someone you met in a past life. You're probably very connected to the moon in this life, but I think there were several moons in that lifetime. But there's a lot, obviously in this deck, there's a lot of cards that have the moon on it, but you had that sort of wisdom. And I think part of what made you fair is your ability to see people's fluctuations in their energy, and then when people have a good day and bad day, it wasn't like a, like if someone were to commit a crime over there, it would be seen as they were just having a bad day, and kind of judging them based on the overall energy of who they were. This is far out, so I apologize. Ten of Wands with the Seven of Swords. And I think this was so important because this deceitful energy, this low vibration, was something that the entire planet was very sensitive to feeling. And so it would feel like a weight on the entire collective when there was just a few people who were not living up to that standard of living, and it's kind of like you snuff them out. Yeah, and then we have the Strength card with the Nine of Cups. That just goes to show your ability to really identify again, those people who are maybe struggling emotionally, and there's just a very strong empathetic intelligence here, and I'm sure that translated to this life, but it's a little different here because there's so much influence, there's so much noise, and it's really downplayed on this planet for now, so that might be part of something that you feel you have to teach the world or embody. And yeah, so let's see. I'm just gonna do an additional, okay, yeah, an additional card from the Dragon Oracle, and then we're gonna see how I could kind of integrate this energy into this lifetime. So Golden Solar Dragon. Helps you stand in your masculine power with wisdom. We also have the Divine Wisdom card here. So maybe while in that star system, there's more feminine energy with the Moon Child, the Strength card, Ten of Cups, Nine of Cups. This one's more about expressing that wisdom and shining bright. Despite being sort of, I wasn't going to say outcast, just being very different from the rest of the people of this planet. Let's see how you could integrate this into erosion. Another card. Influence. Well, I guess with those two, it's like the erosion of the influence that's outside of you. And I'm thinking of, where is it? Yeah, this first card with the Nine of Cups. That's something you could bring into this reality, is kind of blocking, shielding the energy of people around you who are just not as attuned as you are in terms of energetic awareness of like the vibration and so forth. Okay, so this little thing has a bunch of kind of like objects from the Marvel Universe, and I thought I'd integrate in this reading because I was feeling nerdy. And you got the Quantum Bands, which was a weapon that Quasar had. He's like a galactic, he's kind of like Captain Marvel in a way, but this is an incredibly powerful weapon that he uses with his hands. And so, it's interesting because she's using her hands as well. There could be lots of Reiki, but a lot of power, because we have the Strength card too. She's using mudras here in an interesting way. So there's a power with the hands here, and that could be part of the masculine energy in this life, in this earth, that you could be tapping into. Like, you can even, if it resonates, like, tap into the energy of the sun and use the sun as like healing energy, especially in a way that clears the energy of other people who are lower vibrational. We have the Erosion card and influence here looks like the moon, so it could be very influenced by the moon in this life as well. And that's kind of, that influence is a reminder of a galactic past in another star system. So, I know this is really, really quick. Eventually, I'm going to get space decks, but I really wanted to do this topic now. So, hopefully, it was at least interesting, entertaining. Please let me know in the comments what you think, and I hope to see you in the next video. Take care. Hi, Pile 2. If you chose this coin, this is going to be your reading on a past life on another star system. And, like, after doing the first pile and from just what's coming through, I have to say this is definitely a more fun, but far out. It's a far out kind of reading. So hopefully you enjoy, you know. But I'm saying that because it might be kind of hard to resonate with some of these, just because it's really out there, you know. But hopefully it does. Let's get into it. So I have so far, of course, pre-shuffled a few cards. I have your personality, life purpose, ability, and your impact. There was an extra card that fell out. I'll mention that later. Oh, I forgot to do something though. So this is kind of like the star beings. Okay. Kind of where you came from. I have two. Okay, I have three. Which is interesting. Okay. So we have. I mixed these with other things just because I didn't sift through everything. I have elemental. So like elementals, you could have worked with them in that. I'm not gonna bother. It's not gonna show. But you could have worked with elementals in that realm, in that star system. We also have shamanic power animal. So definitely some sort of shamanic influence. We'll get into that a little bit later because I could see how that ties in. And then finally, like for the actual star being, we have Pleiadian. So if you resonate with being Pleiadian, that would be a confirmation. Of course, it doesn't necessarily mean it's exclusively from Pleiades, but a lot of that energy is in this reading. Okay. So for your personality, you have the Four of Cups. And I think here it's a little different. But you're very secretive. In this star system, it was like you were doing stuff that you don't think others would have approved of. And you wanted to keep it under wraps, but there's a lot more to you than what your fellow star beings were doing, and you wanted to keep it under wraps for good reason. So you kind of like played the typical role, and then underneath the surface, you were doing some other stuff, and we'll get into that. For your life purpose, we have the Knight of Wands, and here we go. I think part of it was. You might have done some sort of either communication with other alien races, right? And I think some of these races were not, looked up upon, or they were looked down upon, So this could have been like you were communicating with, like, let's say, for example, reptilians or Anunnaki or the Greys or something like that. I think you were some sort of liaison. You were like a middleman between these different alien species. But this also kind of lends itself to with the power shamanic animal that you were doing shamanic extractions in that star system. I know. You're also sort of a gatekeeper. But there's a strong sense of like going into lower realms or going into places that other people would be afraid of to. Do like intel, and it's really interesting. I don't know. Okay, so with the ability, we have the Ace of Wands. This is a very different looking Ace of Wands. There's that infinity sign, merging of two different energies. So, what I'm also getting at is kind of blending two sides of a coin to. Again, yeah, it's sort of like in the previous pile, but raising the consciousness was really important on this star system. And part of that was going into the depths and kind of learning about other perspectives, right? Okay, so we have the impact that you left, and we have the Six of Pentacles. It's interesting here because I see a hammer. I see strengthening the aura of the planet. I see being grounded. I think the strength comes from understanding, I guess, like the shadow aspect, subconscious, that sort of thing, of the collective. And I think that understanding comes from interacting with other celestial beings. I don't know what that was, but someone's here, I guess. And then the extra card was the Death card. So I think you could have been some sort of like intergalactic shaman. on a past life. We get the same sort of mirroring image, if I could keep this up. This feels somewhat similar. This could be, I think, this is far out. The idea of like the Dreamtime sleeping death was a realm. I mean, we could do that here, I think, with astral travel and dreaming, but I think in this star system with the Pleiadians, it was very different, just the way that they, you, interacted with that realm. I think. I wasn't expecting something so outlandish, but I'm gonna keep going. Like, the technologies that you developed had to do with integrating some of those. It was like you're building a technology in the spirit world, in the dreamscape, but there was a conscious connection to it in the wa waking life. And I think part of the fact that you were the Four of Pentacles, it feels like people didn't fully value what you were doing because they just, not everyone knew about it. And I think some beings thought of this development as sketchy because they just didn't understand that realm as well as you do. I think that this would translate here into being very comfortable in the underworld, being very comfortable with like shadow, because you could see the value in it, and I think even more so in possibly the Pleiadian star system, but in that life that it was integral in creating specific types of technologies that impacted the waking world. And for example, like teleportation would be some sort of thing that I know. But it's like you connected, like there was a device in the dream world, in the spirit world, and like where, dead people would reside, and there was like a device made there so that you could travel through it into another space in physical reality. I know. I hope I'm not losing too many of you, but that's just. I was influenced by this reading because I'm very connected to like the stars and stuff, and I was looking at the Arcturian star, and it just kind of like I physically felt it, of course. It's like do a past life star reading. So I mean, this doesn't really sound too outlandish to me, but I'm kind of curious. I'm hoping I'm not losing you, but I'm gonna look at. I'm just gonna draw out a few more cards to kind of clarify a few things and see what else we can get in this lifetime, okay? What's the past life? Nine of Wands. This Nine of Wands is different. This figure is meditating. It almost looks like opening up to being abducted with this eye up here. But I don't know if I'm being a bit far-fetched when I say this, but it kind of feels like astral projection. Deliberately, this feels like deliberately going into that other realm. I think that's confirmation, to be honest, of that sort of ability, and that would translate into this reality with just lucid dreaming and something like that. But there, it was like physically making something in another realm and integrating it. That's what happens when you're on star systems that are advanced. It's not really too far out. Yeah, the Eight of Pentacles. There's a building here. Man, I'm kind of amazed at this. So you're a very hard worker, and the thing is, the problem is, and this could be something that applies to this reality, is like putting a lot of hard work but not receiving the recognition for it or the accolades. Because it's really not tangible, That I think that might have been like a reoccurring theme with you. the Hanged Man. It's probably how you felt, unmoving, but you got comfortable with it. I think you also, in this reality, bring a very unique perspective. I think part of that perspective is being so close to the spirit world, to the dream time, and things like that, like being very comfortable in other realities and other dimensions. We have the Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, you're like a pioneer in that sense. Especially with the Knight of Wands as well. Lots of moving forward, lots of fiery energy into... you're very passionate about your work and your ability... What was your ability again? The Ace... Yeah, Ace of Cups. I guess that's where the passion came from, is like the mystical and mysterious, and even for an advanced star system, that was something that was far out. We have the Five of Pentacles there. I think that has to go with not only not receiving the amount of money that you should have in this life or in that life, but also difficulty communicating. And I'm saying that because of Mercury and Taurus. Taurus is coming through a few times, but also with the Four of Cups. So there's like a dissonance. You're a little distant from most people on your star system. I don't know if this is something that's happening now. This reading actually isn't about this planet, but hopefully some of this is resonating as like feeling distant, feeling like you have to be careful with what you say because it's just not accepted, even though it's true, you know. Another round of clarifying cards here. The first one that came out is the Ace of Cups, so that's underneath the Nine of Wands, like triple confirmation that you really enjoyed going to these other realms, that you really enjoyed. This was your passion, this was your ability, you know, following your heart center regardless of how other people viewed it, right? Regardless of, you know, even if you weren't making the money or whatever currency they were using, even though you weren't making it, you didn't care. You just found it to be something that lit you up, albeit like something that you couldn't really share as much as you wanted to, just because of the nature of this occupation, if you could say that. Let's do the Eight of Pentacles here. The Devil. That makes sense, right? With the Eight of Pentacles, and I was gonna say that for the Devil, for this card here, which is the Ace of Wands at the bottom, your life purpose. Close to the Devil energy, it's kind of like something that's really taboo, you know. I get that sense here, and working with it, working with the energies or galactic beings, or kind of, you have the shamanic power animal, so you were very safe and confident, so that's why you were completely unafraid, because you had a really strong spiritual team guiding you through these other realms, and you're completely unafraid, and I wouldn't be surprised if you kind of carried some of that too when it comes to trying different things in terms of spirituality or rituals or something like that. It's a complete faith in all, in being in the universe and being one with the universe, and there's really nothing to be afraid of because you are the universe in itself. We have the Knight of Wands, so, and the Knight of Wands is underneath the Hanged Man. The Knight of Wands came out in reverse here, so I feel like you wanted to be a little more out there in terms of this skill, this ability, but you simply couldn't. I'll show you the Devil card too. It's just pink. It's a pink here. So, Knight of Wands, Knight of Pentacles. I think you found a partner who enjoyed doing the same thing you did, which really lit you up, but you both kept it secret. Because I see two Knight of Wands here. There's one guy hiding up here. And this kind of feels like, like interdimensional communication. One's in the ground level and one's up there. I know it's far out, but you made it this far, right? I guess. Let's look at the Nine of Pentacles. Six of Cups. This is talking about, for me, that was... Yeah, you might have met your soulmate in that lifetime, and you actually enjoyed working with them. I think that was probably the thing that lit you up the most, is having someone to do all those crazy working with, like, not, I don't want to say like shadow beings, but just it feels like that realm. Oh god, I can't believe how far out this is. That it came across as like dark entities, but really it was just another dimension. Like, I imagine going into a black hole and going into this like sub universe and communicating with that, and then finally having someone you could do that with. And then I think part of, in this life, there might be a longing for a partner that's like that, you know, that you could really do absolutely anything with, that you can tell them absolutely anything. I think that's why the Four of Cups is there too, is you've been so used to having to withhold who you are, that at this point, it's old. I saw the Tower here, so maybe at some point, people found out about that sort of thing, and it had to come to an end. But and I think with the Five of Pentacles too, I do think that you are connected in this lifetime to your dreams. Given all that's here, that you have really, really powerful dreams. This page is connected to the Five of Pentacles. It just feels like a lot of withholding of communication, withholding of energies, withholding of who you are in that previous life, despite doing so much good work for your star system. It's just a shame it didn't really go... It was mostly unnoticed. So we're gonna get an oracle. It's just a dragon oracle, see whatever comes up, and then I'll draw a couple more to see how you could integrate it into this life. The Omega Dragon. Ooh, this is a trip. I don't know if you chose a different pile, but the Omega Dragon says, harnesses the divine feminine power of creation. Intention, hold your vision, birth higher consciousness. I'm tempted to tie it into the last pile, but I'm gonna not do that. I'm gonna clarify it actually with another tarot card. What's this Omega Dragon about? I mean, obviously very tied to feminine energy with the King of Wands. It's kind of, it almost feels like you're continuing on this path that you started previously in terms of working in the other realms. I mean, I know most of you are doing some sort of spiritual healing work, but this has something to do with it, something that was, or is now, like holistic healing. It's coming up more and more, but, you know, it's not wildly accepted yet, and I think you're just changing from the Knight of Wands, the Page, that sort of energy, into just really just going all out at this point. And with the Omega Dragon with divine feminine energy, this is a big, strong dragon, yeah. So it's really being comfortable in receiving the information and guidance from the spirit world. Okay, so let's see how you could integrate this energy and connect with it in this lifetime. But first, I'm gonna draw an object from the Marvel Universe. I know. The Twilight Sword. Okay. So this is the sword. I don't know if anyone saw Thor Ragnarok. If you remember Surtur, who is this fire demon being from Thor. You know, he had the sword, and it brought forth flame, right? And it has the power to set the universe on fire. It's kind of crazy. But I'm not surprised, because you got the King of Wands. You had previously the Knight of Wands in the bottom, which was your life purpose. This was your life purpose in the previous life, right? So I think it's really shifting the status quo. I think it's really burning what feels comfortable. I think that's why the Tower card was showing up in the bottom there. It's like, all of this work that you've put in, especially in the previous life, in the star system of navigating the shadow and communicating and doing all of that, and being comfortable in just annihilating all of the misconceptions and limiting beliefs of that information as something that was wrong, because there's a lot to be learned from it, I think. And that's why the King of Wands is perfect. With that weapon I just mentioned, with that sword of fire, it's like a divine fire that completely annihilates. And that's the same sword that was used to destroy Asgard, at least in the film. You know, if you remember, he went like, so. But ultimately, they ended up moving to another location and this and that. So, okay, let's see how you could just tap into this energy in this lifetime. Grief. This is cycles of the moon, but also kind of, I don't know, something about crying, and I feel like connecting with a lost spirit as well. So I think part of it might be mediumship. If you resonate with being a medium, that would be like tapping into this past life energy. And then we have patience. So I don't think you fully tapped into this yet, but I think it's coming. And I think this patience has a lot to do with, again, this life in this past star system, in this, star system, where you've been working a lot to bring something forth into light. And I think that's coming in this lifetime. So you have this, if you have this feeling that you just, that you have an idea, but you don't really know what it is, and you want to bring something wildly different into the world, I think that's what this is about. That's what that's about, really. So hopefully this reading was enjoyable, at least entertaining. I know it was a bit out there, but hopefully I'll see you in the next reading. Please like, share, subscribe. I really want to hear about what you thought of this, because I know it was, yeah, very different. But anyway, let me know. And thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you next time. Take care. Hi, Pile 3. If you chose this stone, this tumbled stone, it's actually labradorite. But this is going to be a reading. There we go. Okay. So, a few things. Okay, yeah. So, a few things. One is that these readings have been kind of out there, okay? But I'm also, like, channeling it way faster. And that was the same thing that happened with the celestial guides, where it's just a lot. There's a lot. And but for your reading, for this pile, I have a few, have like a bowl of different races. I don't know all of them, and I don't have any decks that have a bunch of alien races. So I pulled three, and I'm hesitant because I know that many of you, I don't think would like what came out. But there is one race that I associate with, and it's just interesting because the cards that I chose, it's life purpose, your personality, your ability, and your impact. This first round of cards, it really makes sense. It really makes sense, and I'm just hoping that, you know. It's kind of like one of those readings where, like, I feel it could be seen as quite negative, or like your ex is or is leaving you or something like that, but you have to deliver the message. So I'm just letting you know that now. Okay. I'm gonna leave that till after I read these cards, and then we'll continue. Okay. So the first one is the personality. Your personality in this past life in the star system, and we have Aries with the Emperor. Okay. Lots of stability, control, power, very powerful. This is an incredibly powerful pile, okay? So that was your personality, like dictatorial, like leadership, very structured, serious. This is a very or in this lifetime, very serious. So for your life purpose, we have the Seven of Wands, more fire. This one feels, I know it's usually a card of defending yourself, standing up for yourself, building a strong, stable structure and fortifying that structure with more power. There's just a lot of power, a lot of standing up, standing your ground, sort of this. And this could have been the basis for, like, these things feed off of each other. Your personality and your life purpose go together really well. In creating a society that felt like it couldn't be toppled, you know. So we have with your ability the Eight of Wands, more fire. This is usually a card of communication with Mercury and Sagittarius, but it feels a little different with this pile. There's like layers of communication. It's like an ability of yours would be to have like encrypted messages within what you're saying or whatever the language is in the star system. And then your impact is the Ten of Pentacles. So lots of wealth here, lots of stability, sharing it, communication coming through again. I believe this is Mercury. I don't remember. I think it is though, Mercury. And so, creating a really solid place, a really solid, and it's incredibly, there's so much structure here, and power and authority and leadership with who you were in this past star system. So, okay, so I'm gonna let you know what it was. The first one is Arcturian. Well, it's actually the last one. I wanted to pick more just to, you know, Arcturian Council. And this was actually the race, the beings that influenced this reading. This is kind of why this reading is happening. It's because of the Arcturians. But then you also have the Anunnaki and the Reptilians. I know. We're gonna continue and but I find it really interesting that these two races would be here exerting so much control and so much authority and so much fire, and that you like as a being of potentially, like, at least around that energy, you know, maybe you're Arcturian and encountered these beings, but there's a lot of structure here, a lot of leadership and building something, and okay, I'm just gonna continue. This is interesting. It's interesting because it doesn't feel heavy. I'm just like, I don't want, you guys to freak out a little bit. We have the Ten of Wands. This might have felt burdensome at one point. We have Judgment. A toppling of this, this sort of behavior and structure, and we have the King of Cups facing judgment, and the Knight of Cups. I think what, you know, it was funny, because when I originally thought of this reading, I was like, there's going to be one pile that I'm going to have to explain that it's kind of like playing a Star Wars game, like KOTOR or something, or playing Fable, you know, in an RPG when, you know, being an infinite being that you are, and like you play, let's say you play a game and you do one playthrough and you beat the game as the good guy, and then you're like, I kind of wonder what abilities you unlock, what the story, how the story changes if I play like the Sith Lord, and what ability, you know. And I think this is just that playthrough. I think that's just what this is. Like, you've experienced kind of that heaviness that comes with being that way. I think you've experienced kind of the judgment that comes with it as well, of, like, being ultimately unsatisfied with trying to control everything. I feel as though that makes you a lot more attuned and grateful for this lifetime on Earth, where you're connected to, of course, the King of Cups, the Knight of Cups, a lot more emotional energy, the complete opposite of all of the wands that we saw with who you were, with the structure of Emperor Aries, with the Eight of Wands, with the Seven of Wands as well. Really a shift. It's kind of like just experiencing both sides of that in, like, in between these lives. And then we have the Five of Pentacles. Let's clarify these. I'll show you the Judgment card. It's kind of cool. But I do think you bring a wisdom in this. Like, when people say, like, I don't understand why they're, those people exist in the world, like the dictatorial. I'm not saying you were like that, like a dictator or anything, but it's just showing that the need to control everything doesn't necessarily pan out in the best way. We have the Six of Wands, which is victory here. This card feels a lot like integration and celebrating both sides. There's a lot of wisdom that can come from having had this experience where you have a wildly different perspective of, say, the powers that be, that it's kind of like the Eight of Cups. I think maybe at one point there was a transition away from this sort of lifestyle of being very focused on, in this, you know, star system, like finances and accolades and something like that, where you started following your heart more, and maybe that's why the Arcturian race was there. Maybe you met, like, with the Arcturian Council, you just got exposed to a different type of star system, because, like, you could imagine a whole planet or something being just the Emperor, you know, and just, that's just the way things were. It wasn't evil or anything. That was just, the whole world is like that, and That's just considered normal until you get exposure to something different, exposure to a place where that is more heart-centered. If the High Priestess for the Knight of Cups. So there's a strong sense of moving away from this eventually. I think part of your path here has been continuing that motion towards intuition, cups. There's been a lot more cups energy, even with the High Priestess, with the moon with Pisces, you know. Tapping more into the divine feminine, because you might have been very closely associated with the divine masculine, and thinking that's the only way things should be. We have the Five of Wands. Let's clarify this Five of Wands. Six of Cups. I'm going to draw an oracle, but you got the Earth Dragon, which says clears your path and the land around you. Stay grounded. Be ready to serve. Stuck energy is clearing. Stuck energy is clearing. I have 12:21 as well on the clock here. Deep Blue Dragon helps you safe, keeps you safe by clearing your path. Lots of clearing energy. Sunshine Yellow Dragon helps you help animals, serve animals. I think animals are the way that you open your heart again. So you might not be necessarily too connected with the human race, to be honest. And then Rose Pink Dragon. So it's kind of like in this lifetime, part of your experience is opening your heart chakra and really shifting those energies, clearing out those old energies of the past star system, of a need for control and power into harmony. But there's a lot of clearing, so if it's felt heavy for you, that might have been why, and that's just why it feels a bit long, like it's taking long. We have, so I have two Marvel objects here, right? I just wanted to see how I could tie this into Rune, and it kind of makes sense. We have the Ebony Blade, which is the Black Knight's sword, which can cut through anything. It cuts through anything. I think it just goes to show, like, you're the wielder of this blade in the past. And then we have the Dragon Fang, which is Valkyrie's weapon. Valkyrie from Thor. So two weapons showing up. It's just really the yin and yang, experiencing and transitioning into the other side. That's what this life is about. But you do have, if you feel in this life that you're not structured, it's just kind of a confirmation that you do have the ability within you to create that structure and foundation within yourself. And you're very powerful. You have a lot of influence. But also, most of it's like you ended your life there, moving away from that way of being, that just burn down everything sort of thing so I could make my building, you know what I'm saying, like clearing the forest for another building. And I think now you're in a position where you could see with your connection to Earth and its animals, it's helping you open the heart, but from it's like a subconscious perspective of what it would take to shift that energy. You have combustion. Yeah, lots and lots of fire. I think this combustion has to do with your heart center in this lifetime. Opening, clearing, lots of clearing energy. And dreams. I'm surprised this didn't come up in a previous pile, but I would look out for those. If there's a lot of fire, if there's a lot of. It could be not too violent, but like a lot of action in your dreams. That would be a confirmation of that. And again, I'm seeing the animals in these dreams. So it's like animals are the key for you to open your heart and feel connected to this planet and to loving humanity again, you know. Not to say you don't, but structure. Let's see if I can show this. Yeah, this is your energy in this past life. Lots of structure. And it's not bad, you know. You value the security of things, and it is important in creating a stable environment that lasts, you know. So it's kind of what I'm getting at here is an integration of energies. You're just balancing out having too much structure and too much authority, having more of the water with the Ace of Cups, High Priestess, the Knight of King of Cups, integrating more of that energy so it's a lot more balance within you, and that balance manifests on the planet Earth, which is kind of what you're seeing, right? With there's a lot of that, well, you know, the powers that be trying to exert too much influence, having too much influence on responsibilities and like bills and this and that, and kind of bringing up more of the love and taking nurturing energy and the joy, and that's kind of something that's manifesting within you as well as within the earth plane as well. So hopefully this reading was okay. I'm sorry, I didn't know it was gonna be like this, but hopefully you took something from it. It was at least mildly enjoyable. Please comment, please like the video. But don't worry, I'm gonna do some more grounded readings in the future. So hope to see you there. Take care.